Morenai te whānau. So it's day two here at the Parakore Kaupapa in Kirikiroa in Hamilton. And I'm just about to start getting into the breakfast, feeling really tired because I was up late last night prepping things for today. But on the menu this morning we just got a cooked breakfast, creamy mushrooms, hash browns, baked beans, and then some porridge with some fruit. So just gonna get into that now. I had a pretty strange sleep. I kept waking up like every hour thinking I was gonna miss my alarm, but then I was like quietly stoked that I still had heaps of time to sleep. But yeah, so I'm gonna try and vlog as much as I can today. So I'll share some recipes as I go. But yeah, let's go. So this breakfast is pretty straightforward. So basically got everything that I need out here. Just got the hash browns, the baked beans, and chopped up the mushrooms last night. And you always need quite a bit more mushrooms than you think for creamy mushrooms, because mushrooms always go a lot smaller. And then I grabbed some nice fresh bread yesterday, so I'm gonna chop that up for the toast. Also just got some normal bread, and the main thing is make sure you turn on the oven. The first thing that I am going to put on is the hash browns, because they generally take longer than most things, and if they cook before the time, I can just put them in at the end again just to get them reheated. And I've got about an hour until breakfast needs to be ready, so got a bit of time on my hands. But honestly, when you're in the kitchen, time just seems to just go so quick. So we'll see how we go. Let's go.
Brothers and sisters, I want to welcome you back to life, back to the one that can make your next chapter your best chapter. Hallelujah.
How can it be that you love the most unlovable part of me? Of me. How could you see your life was the only gift I'll ever need to be free? It's amazing with you. I win even if I lose. Everything's working for my good for all.
Boom, so that's breakfast, and yes, it's always that hectic. I just can't get time, because even though I think I have heaps of time, there's always like pretty much going right down to the wire. And the main reason is you don't want the food to go out cold, so I try and keep everything on as late as I can. So that's why the last bit's always a damn rush. But pretty stoked with how all that came out. Hopefully there's enough. The creamy mushrooms always sort of like go way down, but we'll see how it goes. Kia ora, e te whānau. So breakfast is all done. Now the next thing on the menu is some scones. That's what's going to be for morning tea. But scones don't really take that long, so what I'm going to do instead is I'm going to start prepping lunch. And lunch, I'm just going to do some salad sandwiches, salad buns, salad wraps. And it's also going to be served with this miso that I prepped last night, but that's so basic to make. But yeah, so I'm just gonna chop up some vegetables and just get all of the sandwich fillings all sorted. And then hopefully by the time I do this, I'll get straight into doing the scones. So let's go. Let's get these people something to eat. Right, so now we're going to get into the scones. And this is the recipe right here. Alright, so we've got 3 cups of flour. I use wholemeal flour. 6 teaspoons of baking powder. 1/4 teaspoon of salt. 75 grams of butter, so you are going to need a scale. And 1 to 1.5 cups of milk. And I always use oat milk. And the 1 to 1.5 depends on the consistency of the mixture. So you just keep adding that until it's at the right consistency. So I'm going to get into this now because morning tea's about 1/2 an hour to 1 hour away. So just want to get ahead of the ball and get this rolling. Let's go. So just going to get into it now. I don't have any measuring cups here. The thing that you can do if you don't have measuring cups is if you just use the same cup for everything. So since I've got flour and milk using cups, I'm just going to use the exact same one. Sweet. So 3 cups of flour, but since there's about 30 people, I might just triple it. So I'm going to go 9 cups. I want to love you and love and treat you right. 9. Every day and every night we'll be together with a roof right over our head. We'll share the shelter of my single bed. Is this love, love, love? Alrighty, so in about 1/2 an hour the oven should be hot. Sure is. And I've got about 36 and a little bit more there, so I'll make sure to put those in too. These should only take about 10 minutes or so. So the reason why I use the cup is just so it gets even and it looks nicer. Also got that from my mama. The next thing I do is, hey Siri, please set an alarm for 10 minutes.
Okay, I set your alarm.
Boom. Now we'll just wait for those to come out. Just gonna serve them with butter and jam. And that's basically it for the morning tea. Probably put out some fruit out as well, or some coconut. But yeah, other than that, I'll show you what it looks like after it's all been set out. All done. Check it out. Not the wholemeal scones. So got the scones. I've already put out the olive, onion, jam out on the table. Also got some fruit out there as well as some coconut yogurt. But I'm just gonna plate this into this and then I'll show you what it all looks like. Morning tea dusted. Now start to prep for lunch. So that was morning tea, scones were a hit. Now I have lunch to do. All the prep is done. I've got sandwiches, so I've just cut up some tomatoes, some cucumber, some red onion, some grated, some carrot, and I'm just going to use these here, some wraps, some sandwiches, as well as some buns I've just made. Beetroot hummus.
All right,
should I do that through our cutting
in? Yep. All right, lunch is ready. My battery went flat, so I couldn't show you how I done it all, but here we go. We just got some salad, wraps, buns, sandwiches as well as a miso soup. Yum! Hopefully everyone enjoys it, eh?
I'm sure they will.
Alright, karanga mai. So that's lunch all done, afternoon tea sort of. They've just gone for a little outing. But I was just gonna go to the grocery store now because I ordered 10 kilos of potatoes, but I only got 10 individual potatoes, so that's not gonna be enough for the mashed potatoes tonight because I'm making a lentil stew. But there's also something in my mind that I know that I should be getting, but I don't know what it is. And I've been trying to think on it, but hopefully it comes to me when I'm walking around the supermarket. But yeah, whew, the energy levels are definitely hitting it. And I still gotta go for my run. All right, Tete Whanau, peace. Back in the kitchen now, Tete Whanau, and I'm just gonna start on this paprika lentil stew. So I've got all these veggies out. I'm gonna be using celery, parsnip, capsicum, kumara, bit of carrot, broccoli, but this goes in last because if you cook broccoli in straight away, it just goes soggy and that's not that great. Always have onion and minced garlic for the base. I'm gonna put some potatoes in there as well, but also gonna use the potatoes for a mash, and then got my lentils here. So this is going to be dinner served with mash, and then I'm going to be making a broccoli salad to have along the side. And then for dessert, it's going to be feijoa stewed feijoa, and I made some granola here last night. You can see it in there. So that's going to be the dessert. Going to have the stew on the stewed feijoa along the bottom, and then gonna top it with the granola. So hopefully we get this all done. Dinner's going to be at 5:30. It's now 10 to 3. So I've got about 2.5 hours to get everything ready. But ready to rock this. Feeling great. I just had a mother. It's probably why I'm so a bit more hyped. And just saw that there was a bloody radio here. So going to get it going. Mauri ore te whanau. Let's see how we rock it. Oots! Today's a new day. A lot since the last snap, but here's our lentil stew. It's going very, very nicely. The potatoes are basically all done, and instead of making a broccoli salad, I rang on my mum and I got some counsel from her. So I'm going to make a broccoli stir fry with kale and silver beet just to use up all the produce. And then we've got these stewed veggies for dessert, and it's all coming together very, very nicely. I'm gonna finish making that stir fry at about 5 o'clock, so just gonna start wrapping things in. But gonna go and set up out here just to make sure it looks all lovely and different. But yeah, chugging along, Tete Whanau. It's so hard vlogging and doing this, but doing it anyway. Let's go. Guys, all ready, check it out. So in the whare at the moment, dinner was a success as well as the pudding. Now just in here, going to be listening to Wairirangi and Tāmoko share their kaupapa around Pipiri kia papa Tupuānuku, and then I'll be getting up to have a bit of a kōrero, and got a little bit more prep to do tonight for the last day tomorrow, but this is how the rest of the night's gonna roll out. Mihi. I'm very much looking forward to hearing these two speak. People out here doing it, Tete Whanau. There are people out here doing it.
Rōwai whakamarumaru ōrangi nui, takoto iho nei, ko ōna parirau e toro tawhiti, hei tāparau I a koe e papa. Nā reira, tēnei tēnā kau o te mihi, e rere atu ki a kōrua. Tēnā kōrua ko tai mai nei te paranatira I te kaupapa, te paranatira I a papa Tupuānuku, I a rangi nui, I te tai a hoki, hora hora I te kaupapa ki te ao whānui. Nā reira, me mihi kātika ki a kōrua, o te huna woke,
And that concludes today, te whānau. Hope you enjoyed this vlog. It's going to be all over the place, I understand that, but this is not as easy as it seems. But I've got more prep to do. There's heaps of things happening, but this is me checking out. Hope you enjoyed the vlog. Let's go!